This illustration is about the sliding of a block over a prism. Here we are given that the figure shows a block B of mass M2 placed on inclined surface of prism A, which is of mass M1. And is saying if ground is smooth and friction coefficient between A and B is mu, we are required to find the acceleration of prism if a system is released from rest. It is also given that alpha is 10 inverse mu. That means alpha is greater than angle of repose. That means B won't be at rest on A. It will start sliding. So here first we can draw the free body diagrams of bodies A and B. So here if we write free body diagram of A. Here to draw free body diagram, let's draw the figure again showing all forces acting on it. Here we are given that ground is smooth and B is sliding on it and this surface is rough. So here we can say here normal reaction acting is N1 and the normal reaction between these two blocks is N2. And in this situation, if B will slide down, it will experience a friction in upward direction F. And in a sliding, we can write it mu N2 if mu is the friction coefficient acting on it. Friction on this prism will act in downward direction. And if we draw the free body diagram of A, here you can see it will experience a downward force. It's a weight that is M1G. The normal reaction due to the block is normal to the incline. This is N2. As the angle of incline is alpha, this is also an angle alpha. The upward force acting on this block is N1. And the friction which is acting along the incline in downward direction, so this will be mu N2. So these are the forces acting on the block A, and we can consider block A is moving toward right with an acceleration A1. This will go toward right with acceleration A1. Similarly, we can draw the free body diagram of block B, which is resting on block A. And as it is on an incline, which is accelerating, so it is better to solve it in the non-inertial reference frame by considering pseudo force on it. So this is the surface of prism on which the block is experiencing its weight M2G. One normal reaction N2 will act on it in this direction. And as the prism is accelerating toward right with acceleration A1, this will experience a pseudo force over here, which is M2A1. And as it is sliding down, we can say its friction on it will be mu N2 in this direction. And this angle is alpha, as this is alpha. And we consider the motion of block B with respect to the prism is with acceleration A2. Here we assume B is accelerating with acceleration A2 with respect to block A. Here we are taking it with respect to block A because we have taken pseudo force and analyzing B with respect to A. So if we write the equations of motion for these blocks, here you can see for block A, as it is moving toward right in this direction of acceleration, it is having a force N2 sine alpha. In opposite direction, it is minus, as this angle is alpha, this is also alpha. This force is mu N2 cos alpha, which is equals to M1 A1. Say this is our first equation. And for block B, there is no use to draw the vertical direction equation for A as it is not moving vertically. And ground is also smooth. Now we can write the equation of motion for B. So as it is sliding in downward direction, one force acting on it is M2 A1 cos alpha. So this will be M2 A1 cos alpha plus it is M2 G sine alpha minus the friction is mu N2, which is equals to M2 A2. That is your equation 2. Third equation we can draw in normal direction to the prism surface where the block B is not moving. So here we can write the value of N2 in upward direction plus we can write M2 A1 sine alpha and on the other side it is m2g cos alpha. So we can directly write the value of n2 as m2g cos alpha minus m2a1 sin alpha, that is your equation 3. And here from equation 1 and 3 we can eliminate the value of n2 and get the value of acceleration, because we are interested in calculating the acceleration of prism. As block B acceleration is not required, this equation we are not going to use. So we can directly write from equation 1 and 3, we can substitute the value of n2 over here. So you can see directly I can substitute, so it will be m2g cos alpha minus m2a1 sin alpha. This is the value of n2. If I take n2 common out, this will be multiplied with the sin alpha minus mu cos alpha is equals to m1a1. We can open these terms which are in product and solve it for a1, and you can see if we further simplify it, this will give us m2g cos alpha sin alpha minus mu m2g cos square alpha minus m2a1 sin square alpha plus mu m2a1 sin alpha cos alpha, that is equals to m1a1. So these are the two terms of a1. We can take these two terms on the right hand side and simplify. So this will give us the value of a1 as, here we can take g common out. So this will be m2 sin alpha cos alpha minus mu m2 cos square alpha divided by the terms of a1. We can write that is m1 plus m2 sin square alpha minus mu m2 sin alpha cos alpha. So this is the final result of this problem, which is the acceleration of the prism when the system is released from rest.